I'm employed by Cisco, but I'm speaking here as an advisor to the Swedish government, and the Swedish government, just like many other governments, have been looking in various ways of getting IPv6 deployed. From a government perspective, we have seen various models for governments to try to get more effective addressing, regardless what protocol it is. You have a government can you have different tools they can use. They can just subsidize and give away money to have to the market, and they can also, of course, legislate, but then they can also be a procurer. So those are, well, and then you have, of course, also government just making statements, because you should not underestimate the power of someone just making a statement. So you have these four tools, and given how fast the internet and telecommunication is evolving, we have seen that subsidy is one thing, of course, that has been very effective, but the problem for government is then to stop the subsidy. What then happens? To a certain degree, it's better to give money for people to turn off things than turn on things. Because if you give money for people to turn off things, at one day everything is turned off and you don't have to pay more. If you pay people to turn on things, more and more people will turn on things and you just have to pay more and more and more until you say stop. And what then happens? Okay. So subsidy for turning on IPv6 is problematic. Legislation is pretty slow, but a much, much faster tool, and we've seen that in the United States regarding IPv6, being a procurer is extremely effective. Because if a government, which actually is a very big buyer of services and goods, if they say, we require this or else we will not buy your product, people are very often lining up and changing according to what the government wants. Of course, that requires that the government really writes correct RFPs. High quality RFPs, and that's one of the areas where some governments do understand that they need to work more together with the community, internet community and private sector and civil society, to make sure that the RFPs include the right stuff. Because if the government, on the other hand, just because procurement is so powerful, if they require the wrong things, it can go really wrong. So, if the government is then as a provider of services, it's very important for the government that anyone can access their services, just like any private company is interested in having as many customers as possible or internet users be able to access their services. And for example, the Swedish government has very explicitly said that they have as a goal that anyone should be able to access any service from anywhere. So what the government, of course, is nervous about is that if it is the case that a lot of people are, for example, filing their taxes online, the day when the first consumer, a citizen, or person or entity that is to file their taxes only have an IPv6 address, they must still be able to file their taxes. So at that point in time, which might be some time from now in the future, but that point in time, all the e-services that the government provides must be available over IPv6.